Hey, well, on my right, but always political left, Ogie Overman, the great broadcaster and journalist David Daggett, who we held over from the last segment, talking about school bus safety. And now David's on the roundtable, and Keith Granberry, founder of Helping Hands Consultants. Guys, here in America, we excoriate anyone or his business or family if their wealth was based on slavery or some atrocity. Meaning no disrespect to the late queen, but her family has gained wealth down through centuries of slavery, of torture in some cases, all sorts of things. So, I mean, are we hypocrites? Try to help me understand, because we seem to be so obsessed with the royal family, and yet back here, if they had done the things they had done over the centuries, we would excoriate them. Ogie.
Well, first of all, there's that we tend to gloss over these things because of our shared ancestry. We were settled by the English initially. But the real fact is that we're guilty of absolute same atrocities. There's this small matter of several centuries of slavery, destroying American Indian culture.
And yet we let
Japanese
it slide.
With internment.
We think the queen and the king, they're great.
Well, it's the government and the monarchy are two separate things anyway.
Yeah, but you know people don't realize that the monarchy, the queen, the king has control. They can suspend parliament. They can start a war. They have a lot of powers they don't use.
Yeah,
but I'm talking about centuries past. David.
Yeah, I think it's an interesting thing. Now, I'm not a lover of the monarchy, but times have changed. Paradoxically, the monarchy in recent years has been an advocate for equal rights across all people.
I'd be an advocate too if I had $50 billion from
and that sort of thing. The other thing that they have done is the other benefit of the monarchy is in these polarized times, they've kind of been a rudder of being agnostically in the middle and not following politics. I think that's helpful.
Are we hypocrites or what?
Absolutely hypocrites. The American economy was built on the back of slaveries. I mean, of slaves. So we can't really look at it as being hypocrites because the nation that we're in was created and built on slaves. So therefore, the slaves themselves haven't received anything from that. And so we can't really look at it as different. I think it's the same. And the monarchy is just an image, marketing campaign. That's what we're dealing with, a marketing campaign.
All right, former state legislator Derwin Montgomery was recently charged with embezzlement. I don't want to discuss his case, but here's what I want to get to. He turned himself in. He said he's not guilty. And yet when he appeared in court, he was fully shackled, like, you know, hands, feet, the whole thing, as they seem to do with anybody who comes in there. My question, guys, is this seems a little extreme. In general, should folks charged with a nonviolent crime be shackled when they're just going before the judge? Ogie.
I wonder if the fact that he's a black man had anything to do with it.
I don't know. David, do you have any insight on that?
Yeah, I've been in court a lot of times over the years. I don't handle criminal cases anymore. I was a little surprised when I saw the video of that.
Key.
I think it's a shame that that man came into the courtroom shackled, and I think it does boil down to race in a lot of different ways. And I think sometimes as politicians, we get treated differently, especially black politicians, when they get in situations like that. So I think it definitely deals with race.
Well, I hope he comes out okay. Good guy. He appeared on the show before. The town of Kernersville is still struggling with enforcement of their new noise ordinance. Recently, police repeatedly warned one bar owner, you got to tone it down or we're going to cite you and the band. And they did. Here's my quick question. We don't want to spend a lot of time on this, but in general, I think we know that a venue operator, a bar owner, whatever, if he's guilty of something, that's one thing. Should members of a band be cited for that or just the owner?
No, you can't penalize the band. We used to play in a club in Kernersville and outside, and they'd shut us down every time.
But you didn't get an individual citation.
No, the band,
Don't plead guilty. This wasn't Ogie we're talking about, was it?
That's right. What do you think? Should individual?
I think I look at it as the captain of the ship doctrine. Is it should be the owner of the establishment should control the band or what it has.
Just the owner or members of the band?
Depending on if the band is good or not. No, I'm just kidding. No, it's the owners. It's the owners. It's definitely the owners.
All right.
That's right.
That's right. In order to combat rising crime in Forsyth County, District Attorney Jim O'Neill is proposing a juvenile curfew be imposed from 10 p.m. to 6 a.m. Good idea or bad idea, Ogie?
You know, I thought Greensboro tried this a few years back with kids running crazy downtown, and it actually kind of worked. They did it temporarily, and they beefed up the bicycle cops, and it pretty much worked.
What do you think, Mr. Daggett?
Yeah, I think it's problematic. It's problematic from several points of view. One is the kids that aren't causing problems, they're being punished too. And then you have enforcement issues. What about somebody who works late and
right,
is
right.
driving home? And, you know, who's going to arbitrate and legislate all these different scenarios that come up? You have a babysitting job.
Yeah.
You're picking up dad at the airport when he flies in on a late
flight. Or playing sports. Yeah,
how are you going to do this?
Yeah, Keith, what do you think?
I think this is political. I mean, I'm not trying to be political, but Judge Hartsfield is a person who believes that going into community is more important than doing curfews. Being a part of the community's police, community policing, those are things that we need to do.
All right, good thought. Finally, the Huffington Post reports that defective sex toys are now being recycled and made into shoes by the Good Faith Shoe Company. Guys, would you buy a pair of these recycled shoes, Ogie?
Where can you get them? Is it online?
I don't know, but David, would you buy?
Well, I have to defer to Ogie on this one. Ogie's one of my heroes, so I defer to Ogie on this one.
Keith, would you wear a pair of shoes made from defective sex toys?
I love shoes, but I'm not wearing anything that's defective. I don't want anything defective around me. Stay away from defective stuff.
Yeah, I can tell you three things that are defective right here. All right, well, that's, guys, thanks for hanging here. Ogie's 18th year, Keith's 17th, Dave's eighth year on the roundtable. We appreciate all your help over the years, guys.
Happy 900.
Yeah, thank you. Appreciate it.
I'm and the that's, star of the show.
We should sing that to you.
Yes, that's right. Just about
Happy
all the time. That's
you.
Right. That's all the time. Oh, well, I don't know what I forgot to say. Last week, a Southwest Airlines pilot threatened to turn the plane around and go back if one male passenger didn't stop sending nude photos to all the other passengers. Quote, "I'm sorry, I didn't know it was against the rules," said Ogie Overman.
That would be something he would say.
Yeah, for all of us here on Try Today, we'll see you next week.